तो उसका टेंशन मत लेना आप. नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट विद साइंस लेक्चर. एवरीवन इज एक्साइटेड अबाउट साइंस, राइट? रिप्लाई करो यस और नॉट. आर यू एक्साइटेड अबाउट साइंस? ग्रेट ग्रेट ग्रेट. यस 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 यस. गुड, नाइस नाइस. स्टूडेंट्स आर वेरी कोऑपरेटिव, वेरी स्वीट स्टूडेंट्स, नाइस. अच्छा, कीप अ नोटबुक विथ यू, ठीक है? व्हेन द लेक्चर स्टार्ट्स, तो कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट चीजें आप लिख सकते हो. या अभी हम लोग लेक्चर चालू करेंगे, ठीक है? गौरी मैम.
यस सर, आई एम हियर.
यस यस यस, यू कैन स्टार्ट द लेक्चर मैम. यू कैन स्टार्ट द साइंस लेक्चर. स्टूडेंट्स आर वेटिंग फॉर यू.
ओके.
या
Yeah, good afternoon, students. Very warm welcome to all of you. Since this is your first science lecture, let me start this lecture by introducing myself. My name is Gauri Swati, and I teach biology for 8th, 9th, and 10th standard. Today, we will be starting with the very first chapter of our 8th standard, which is living world and classification of microbes. Now, before we start with the actual biology, I want to give you some tips, or you can say some background about biology, that what is exactly biology? Because until now, we all were studying general science. Okay? So biology, let's just split the word into two parts. D-I-O, bio, which means living, and ology means the study of. So the meaning of the word biology is the study of living beings. Simple as that. And in this biology, we have everything about the living creatures. That is about plants, about animals, about microbes, reptiles, birds, wildlife, everything. Okay? So, yeah, I'm also very happy to see your excitement for today's lecture. So before we begin our biology lecture, let me tell you something, that every lecture of mine, I will be giving you few words. Now, what are these words about? See, when we were child, before we started learning English, it was important for us to understand and learn few alphabets. Similarly, to understand few terminologies of biology, all the new upcoming words will be first taught to you. So what you have pen for today, it will be just a generic information. We will begin with the chapter, but from next lecture onwards, the first slide which you will always see will belong to dictionary words. So I will teach you few words. The meaning will be given to you. We will understand it nicely, and then we will begin with that particular day's topic. Okay? So let me quickly share my screen with you all. Okay, here we are. So this is our lesson number one, which is living world and classification of microbes. Now you are able to see a frame of pictures. Okay? All these animals, birds are mixed up, and this is nothing but all living creatures put together in a frame. If I'm seeing all these animals, they are divided by specific frames. Why? Because they all are classified. And what we have to learn today is classification. And why are we studying, or why is it need to study classification? So before, let me tell you, our Earth is home for 87 million species. Now, 87 million, can you imagine how, I'm not telling total number of creatures. I am telling total number of different type of animals, plants, and birds present on this earth. Now you might be knowing that 1 million is equal to 10 lakhs. And when I'm speaking about 87 million, just imagine the number. 87 million. So many different type of organisms are already present on the earth. And yet we are not knowing few of them. There are many more to count. Okay. Now, if I am going to study these living creatures all together, won't you think it will be difficult for me to study a plant, to study a microbe, to study an animal? So what we have done, we have started classifying them to make our work easier. Okay? let's move on. Now we will add, I'm going to add few animals to your slide. Okay, let's complete this slide in a very colorful way. What we are able to see are aquatic animals. Now this will be your first dictionary word, aquatic animals which live inside water and who are adapted to environment inside water are called as aquatic animals. The spelling is aquatic, aquatic animals. Now there are aquatic animals, there are aquatic plants, there are also aquatic microorganisms. Okay, so we will slowly and eventually look at how different type of living creatures we have here. So what you are able to see is a jellyfish on your right hand side, followed by a shark, and at the left bottom you have a humpback, you have an orca, which is nothing but a killer whale. Now these are aquatic animals. Now let's go to a next step. It's a normal plant. It's a green color grassy plant. Now we have a more developed plant, but this is a non-flowering plant. Please kindly please switch off your videos. I'm still able to see few people with their video pop up. Redmi, someone with the Redmi, a girl, please switch off your video. Let me do this now. Yep. Thank you. Now here comes a flowering plant. Now all these three types of plants are still different from each other. Take care. What next? We are going to study about amphibians. What is amphibians? Plants and animals which are adapted to live on water as well as on land. Examples what we are able to see are a frog, a snake, and a crocodile. Okay, in amphibians evolve hue reptiles and insects. At the leftmost corner we have a mosquito. From then we have a butterfly, a ladybug, a grasshopper, and a peacock bug at the rightmost extreme. Now from this, different type of animals started on evolving, which also lead to smallest of the creature which you are able to see on the screen till the largest of the creature like dinosaur. And few of the dinosaurs started adapting to, you know, showing a nice wings. And from these creatures were evolved birds and different animals. Okay. And meanwhile, when we know all these animals, we are forgetting one of the most important living creatures. And organisms, matlab living organisms. Are you able to see the small? Are you able to see the small pop-up at the left corner? Yeah, and few more, and few more. So these recent pop-ups are nothing but microorganisms. And in this chapter, we are going to explore more about microorganisms. Now, let's move ahead. Why do we have to study classification? Now, we will understand this one by one because you all know.
Sorry, ma'am.
Yeah.
Gauri, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Your voice was lagging. Can you repeat the last part again?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, ma'am? Okay.
Thank you. Okay. Welcome. So in this slide, we have seen many animals and many plants, and they are evolved from different backgrounds. Some belong to water, some belong to the both places, water as well as land. We call them as amphibians. Some are crawling animals, we call them as reptiles. Some fly, we call them as insects. Some have evolved more from animals like deer. Then from deer, which is mammals, we have huge or bigger animals like dinosaurs. and few dinosaurs again started showing adaptation like wings. And from these animals were evolved something like birds. And meanwhile, in order to see all these living creatures, which we are able to see them or, you know, visualize them from naked eyes, we miss the most interesting and important part. Now, which are they? These are also living organisms, but they are very small. Small and organisms means living beings. Okay, now you'll be able to see them at the leftmost corner, right between the frog and the bug, below the flowering plant, above the crocodile, and at the right corner extreme bottom. So these are microorganisms. Now the most famous microbe which we are talking about, you know, in these days is nothing but our COVID-19. What is it? It is a virus, and a virus is nothing but a microorganism, right? So slowly and eventually, before going or before entering the world of microorganisms, we will understand why do we have to learn this classification? Why is it inculcated in my syllabus? Now let's go ahead one by one. Okay, study classification. Let's understand that life on Earth is evolved from a small little cell, and this small little cell went on evolving more and more, and from this one tiny cell itself we today have so many organisms. Can you believe 87 million organisms? So by studying classification, it makes us our work easier to classify them and to study each group individually. So classification is inculcated in our syllabus to study animals, plants, and microorganisms in a systematical way. Okay, this is one of the major reason why we are going to study classification. Now the second important reason, which I just mentioned, is we all are evolved from a common ancestor. We know that humans are evolved from apes. But what are apes evolved from? Apes are evolved from more smaller creatures. Now just when we will start date backing this most common ancestor, we all belong to that common cell which led to life on Earth. Are you able to see the diagram? You'll see a single cell became a unicellular, then chordates, then fish, with, you know, adaptation which led to amphibians. Aise animals jo land and water dono jagah pe reh sakte hai. From amphibians evolved reptiles. Okay, reptiles showed adaptations like having scales, having claws, having digits. Unke baad came animals which started crawling and moving more on the tree. Then were developed animals on, you know, tree living. Finally the apes, and finally humans. So we need to study all this classification to understand how evolution has progressed. And if we understand how evolution has progressed, it will be easier for us to understand what are the diseases which we are going to be affected, what could be the remedy, what are the effects, and many more things. Okay, so two major reasons why studying class. The next slide. Okay, and this next slide will let us help am I audible, Nishant sir? Okay, students, if in case my voice is not clear, any one of you can please ping it to me over the chat box so that I can understand and nobody can miss on anything.
Yes, ma'am. Gauri, ma'am, I think so. Last part was not audible clearly.
About this slide, right? So, thank you.
Yes.
Yeah. Sir, in case is any technical glitch in between, please to ping it on the chat box so that I can understand. I'll stop it right there.
Yeah.
Yep, thank you. So we mentioned in this slide that the two major reasons why we will be studying classification is, number one, to study animals in a more systematic way, and number two, to study evolution. Now, why do we have to study evolution? Because evolution acts as the backbone of any studies in biology. For example, if I need to study that what could be the disease occurring to a mango plant, uske liye first I need to study ki mango kaun se fruit se evolve hua hai. Agar mujhe wo pata chala, toh it becomes easier for me to understand mango tree in a better way. Simple as that. So let's move on to our next slide. And in this next slide, we will be talking about how and what are we going to study? So, number one, taxonomy. What is taxonomy? Any type of study which describes classification is called as taxonomy. So, you take a bunch of reptiles, you take a bunch of animals, you take plants, you take microbes. Kisi bhi living organism ka agar hum log classification padhne wale hai, usko hum log taxonomy kehte hai. Taxonomy is nothing. Now, the definition of taxonomy is, it is the branch of biology which deals with classification of any living organism. Okay? Now, what is the meaning of classification? The process of dividing living organism into groups and subgroups is called as biological classification. Now, this is the exact definition which is present even in your textbook. You can directly refer to the first page of your textbook. There is no hurry to. Now, what are we going to study? We are going to follow classification given by Robert Whittaker. Now, there are many people who started classifying living organisms since 17th century. Now we are going to learn the most advanced type of classification, and this most advanced type of classification is given to us by Sir Robert H. Whittaker, and the name of the classification is Five Kingdom Classification. I am repeating, don't worry. Yes, I am repeating. Taxonomy. So if we are studying classification about any organism, any living organism, it is straight away called as taxonomy. So taxonomy ka meaning kya hai? It is branch of biology which deals with classification of any living organism. Okay? Now let's come to the second point, which is the definition of biological classification. Now, the second point which you are able to see on your screen is the exact definition of biological classification given in your textbook. Okay? I will read it out for you. It is the process of dividing living organisms into groups and subgroups. This is called as biological classification. Now, abhi hum log kaun sa classification padhne wale? Because there were also scientists date back in 16th century, 17th century. And when they were studying science, they were coming across many, many new things. So, classification start hua kafi pehle. Hum log jo padhne wale hai is the most advanced type of classification. And this most advanced type of classification is given to us by Sir Robert Whittaker, and the name of the classification is Five Kingdom Classification. Abhi Five Kingdom Classification ka meaning kya hai? We are going to study five major groups, and this five major groups, each one group is called as kingdom, kyunki ek kafi bada group hai. एंड इसमें टोटल 5 ग्रुप्स है, इसीलिए इस क्लासिफिकेशन का नाम है 5 किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन. ठीक है, आर यू सेट टिल देन? लेट्स मूव ऑन टू नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. History. Now, before diving into the concept of 5 kingdom classification, let us remember the people who have contributed to the history of classification. Okay, thank you, students, for informing me in between if my voice is not clear. Let's move on one by one. So Carl Linnaeus in 1735 divided the living world, that means living organisms, into 2 kingdoms. Number one, vegetabilia, and number 2, animalia. ठीक है, मतलब एक जो हरे दिखते green color vegetables are grouped in one group and animals are grouped into second group. ठीक है, simple as that. Okay, now let's move on to the second point. Haeckel, it is the name of a person. Haeckel in 1866 considered 3 kingdoms. Usne kya kiya? Because see, there is a gap of almost 1 century in between, almost 100 years. And obviously, is 100 years mein kafi zyada progress hua rahega. So Haeckel ne usme aur ek kingdom introduce kiya, and the name of this kingdom is Protista. Now, what is Protista? We will be learning, you know, with a deeper knowledge in the further upcoming slides, but let us just understand the background. Haeckel in 1866 considered 3 kingdoms, and now we have come to 3 kingdom classification, which is Protista, plants, and animals. In 1925, Chatin created 2 groups. What is this 2 groups about? Number 1 group is called as prokaryotes, P-R-O, pro, K-A-R, karyotes, Y-O-T-E-S, and eukaryotes. I am repeating it once again. In 1925, Chatin created 2 groups. Number 1, prokaryotes. Number 2, eukaryotes. Abhi prokaryotes and eukaryotes kya hai? Now, before going to the further thing, animals and plants जिनके पास पुराने टाइप वाला सेल है, and पुराने टाइप वाले सेल को हम लोग क्या कहते हैं? Prokaryotic cell. तो जितने भी लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स के पास ये पुराने टाइप वाला मतलब prokaryotic cell है, उन सारे लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स को हम लोग क्या कहते हैं? Prokaryotes. And जो भी plants and animals एडवांस टाइप वाला सेल दिखाते हैं, दैट इज यूकैरियोटिक सेल. टू ऑल दोस प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स एंड माइक्रोब्स वी कॉल देम एज यूकैरियोट्स. सिंपल एज दैट. वी विल बी फर्दर स्टडीइंग दिस प्रोकैरियोट्स एंड यूकैरियोट्स एज वेल. नाउ द फोर्थ पॉइंट, दिस इज द लास्ट पॉइंट ऑफ योर हिस्ट्री. दैट मीन्स इन द ईयर 1938 कोपलैंड, इट्स अगेन द नेम ऑफ अ साइंटिस्ट, he divided the living organisms into 4 kingdoms. Now, which is the new kingdom which has entered? It is Monera. Okay? So, the 4 kingdoms right now which we have are Monera, Protista, plants, and animals. Simple. Copeland in the year 1938 divided the living organisms into 4 kingdoms. First as Monera, second as Protista, थर्ड प्लांट्स एंड फोर्थ एनिमल्स. अभी इसके आगे जो भी क्लासिफिकेशन आया, दैट वाज गिवन बाय सर रॉबर्ट विटेकर, एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज 5 किंगडम ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन. अब तक का सबसे एडवांस टाइप ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन. एंड द 4 पॉइंट्स व्हिच यू आर एबल टू सी ऑन योर स्क्रीन राइट नाउ इज अ 2 मार्क आंसर ऑफ द क्वेश्चन एक्सप्लेन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन. 2 मार्क के लिए 4 पॉइंट्स आएंगे. Each 1 point will fetch you 0.5 mark. All set? Okay. So we are done with the history part. Now let's go to what are we going to study? 5 kingdom classification. Let's have a look at Sir Robert Whittaker ki wo dikhte kaise the. This is how the gentleman looked. Sir Robert H. Whittaker, and he gave the five kingdom classification in the year 1969. And obviously, even after 1969, there are many more advancements made, but not by him. They were made by other scientists who went on studying taxonomy further. I hope till now everything is clear to you. Now, we come to a magic chart. Now, what is this magic chart? This is going to be the chart which you will learn in your 8th standard, which you will learn even in your 9th standard, and you will have the same chart even in your 10th standard. The chart is about five kingdom classification. And in this chart, we have our complete biology syllabus of taxonomy. ऐसे मैं क्यों बोल रही हूँ? क्योंकि in 8th standard, we will be studying three kingdoms, the first three kingdoms. In 9th standard, we will be studying the fourth kingdom. And in 10th standard, we will be studying the fifth kingdom. This is how by the end of 10th standard, we will be studying complete five kingdom classification. So your biology base begins from 8th standard. Do take it very seriously. Okay? I will proceed. Living organisms are divided into two major groups. Number one, the one which had prokaryotic cell. And number two, the one which had eukaryotic cell. Now, when you must have learned about cell, you know that within a cell, we have nucleus, we have mitochondrion, we have Golgi bodies, we have endoplasmic reticulum. I think few words will be very much new to you. But you all know that the most smallest living unit of any living being is a cell. अभी पुराने वाला टाइप का सेल मतलब क्या? That means prokaryotic cell में ऐसा क्या different है जो eukaryotic cell में नहीं है? We all know that each and every cell has a nucleus. और इस nucleus को एक covering रहता है. Name of the covering is nuclear membrane. I'm repeating it. हर एक सेल में एक nucleus है. And इस nucleus को एक covering रहता है. Name of this covering is nuclear membrane. जिस सेल के nucleus को ये covering है ही नहीं, I meant the cell inside which the nucleus is missing out its covering is called as prokaryotic cell. क्योंकि अगर covering नहीं है, तो don't you think nucleus के अंदर का material पूरा ऐसा फैल जाएगा cell में, बिखर जाएगा? It will scatter. Such type of cell will be called as prokaryotic cell, while the cell जिसके अंदर की nucleus को covering है, that means nuclear membrane present है, these type of cells will be called as eukaryotic cells, the advanced type of cells. And we as humans have eukaryotic cells, advanced type वाला cell. ठीक है? Now let's go one step ahead. Prokaryotic group will show presence of the first kingdom, and the name of this kingdom is Kingdom Monera. This is the first kingdom which we are going to learn in our 8th standard. So prokaryotic mein sirf ek hi kingdom hai, which is Kingdom Monera. Simple. Now let's move on to the second group, which is eukaryotes. Eukaryotic cell जिसके जिस भी plants animals में रहेगा उस सारी living organisms को हम लोग कहेंगे eukaryotes. सिर्फ spelling में इतना ही difference रहेगा, after y o it will be t e s, tick का i c निकाल देना है. ठीक है? Now let's move on to eukaryotic organisms, and inside eukaryotic organisms we have two major criterias. Number one, unicellular, मतलब ऐसी ऑर्गेनिजम्स जिनकी एंटायर बॉडी में सिर्फ एक ही सेल है. नंबर टू, मल्टी सेलुलर, जिसकी बॉडी इज मोर देन सिंगल सेल. ठीक है? नाउ वी विल फर्स्ट स्टडी ऑर्गेनिजम्स कमिंग अंडर यूकैरियोटिक ऑर्गेनिज्म में यूनिसेलुलर. ठीक है? Eukaryotic cell मतलब all the cell in which the nucleus will be well defined. And eukaryotic के group में we have two classifications further. Number one, unicellular. Unica meaning is single. single. Matlab, puri body is just made up of a single cell. So imagine how small will be that organism. Theek hai? And under multicellular, the body of the organism will obviously have more than one cell. Such type of organisms will come under multicellular organisms. Now let's move on to one step further. Under unicellular, we have our second group, second kingdom. And the name of this kingdom is Kingdom Protista. What is the name of the kingdom? The name is Kingdom Protista. Now let's move on to multicellular. Multicellular ke andar hum log ke paas kitne kingdom rahenge? Teen kingdom. Kyunki do kingdom ho gaye. Kingdom Monera and Kingdom Protista. Now let's have a look at these three kingdoms. Number one being fungi or fungi. Abhi jo screen pe teen kingdoms dikh rahe hain, Monera, Protista and fungi. Hum log ko ye 8th standard mein padhne hain. Remaining two kingdoms are out of the syllabus for 8th standard, which is Kingdom Plantae, which you will be studying in 9th standard, and Kingdom Animalia, which we will be studying in our 10th standard. Okay? So this is the common chart which we will study as five kingdom classification given by Sir Robert Whittaker in our 8th, 9th, 10th, and even in your 11th and 12th standard, if you're further going to take biology. Okay. For now, we only have to focus on three kingdoms, that is Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, and Kingdom Fungi. And even this table is given in your textbook, which is asked as a question for 3-mark diagram. If this question comes, classify the living organisms, you will have to draw this same chart exactly, and it will fetch you 3 marks. Am I extremely clear? Now, is there anybody? I have seen somebody raising their hands. Is there any doubt? Till now? Because we are done with our timing for the day.
Students, you can ask your doubts through chat. If you have any doubts, you can text your doubts through chat if you have any. I think so. Oh, they don't have.
They are messaging me privately, sir. So their messages are no miss, no doubt. Is there any homework? So for today, there is absolutely no homework. Mm-hmm. What is the meaning of Protista? It is just a name. It is name given to it. We will be studying these three kingdoms in detail. You do not have to worry about it. Okay, cool. There's no doubt for now. If in case you have any doubts, we will be, you know, continuing it in the next lecture of mine.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah, sir.
Somebody has asked meaning of Monera.
Sir, Monera and Protista, both these are names. And like my name is Gauri, what is the meaning of Gauri? Nothing. It's a name. So it's a name given to the animal. And most of the time, the scientist who used to invent them used to give their own name to the creatures. And like you must have heard about mitochondria. Now, if you don't know, mitochondria is actually surname of a person who stayed in Greece. There's one more doubt. Ma'am, in prokaryotic, unicellular will not come as it is in the textbook. I didn't get your doubt. It is asked by Himani. The chart which you are able to see is ditto what is there in your textbook. You don't have to worry about it. Yes, sir, there are no doubts even on my private chat as well.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you, students. Have a great day.
Okay. Hello, students. We are done with science lecture. I hope you understood the lecture. I hope you enjoyed the lecture. You can reply me through chat if you enjoyed the lecture. Great, great. PPT makes it easy to understand. Nice. Awesome. Good. Now, there are some things which I have to discuss with you. I'll do it very crisply and shortly. So, thoda dhyan dena yahan pe. Main kya bol raha hu? Yes, you enjoyed. I'm happy that you guys are enjoying the lecture. Acha. First thing is that you should not on your video during the lectures because internet lag hoga. Second thing is, aapke jo lectures honge, aapka internet bhi check karna because if your internet is slow, tabhi bhi aapko voice crack hoga, voice lag hoga. So you check your internet also when the lectures are going on. Wo bhi ek reason ho sakta hai. Next thing is, जो भी lectures होंगे उसका recorded links आपको WhatsApp में दिया जाएगा, so you can go through that lectures again if you want to. So don't worry, if you miss something, the lecture has been recorded, तो आपको वो WhatsApp group पे आ जाएगा. So you don't have to worry that कि आपका lecture miss हो गया तो आप कैसे उसको attend करेंगे. And next thing is that कि in the next lecture, I want you to bring your friends. Share this link with your friends who are in 8th standard. Call them. Okay? And we'll be like, aap unko bhi bulao, phir ye lectures un log bhi enjoy karenge. Yes, in your WhatsApp group. Aapka ek WhatsApp group bana hua rahega 8th standard ka. WhatsApp group pe aa jayega. Okay? And now the next lecture will be on Wednesday. You'll get your timetable on your WhatsApp group. So for now, we'll take a leave. Enjoy your day. Take care. Bye. Bye all. Bye students.